Now let's take care of these animation parts. If we reload, the first thing you may see that it is rotating for thrice. It is getting stopped. This, the middle one, getting started, and it is now rotating thrice. And after it is being stopped, the third one is now rotating. It is also rotating for three times, and then it will stop. This is one we know as the animation setting. We have to set some animation timings, and that is why we need to get back to our project, and here we need to specify all those animations. Press F12, select this arrow selector, and choose any one of these font awesome icons, and you may see that inside this fast spin class, here goes the animation. So all you need to do first, copy it, get back to your project, and here, in the first case, when your page is getting loaded, this should be the order. Watch it over here carefully. First one stopped, second one is now started. Second one stopped, third one is now started. Nothing is animating over here. This is the display that we need to do over here. In the first case, we are practically using an infinite option. We do not need any infinite option. Instead, you may use here 3. That means it will be rotating 3 times. You may reduce this period of oscillation over here. Copy this thing. Copy. Now beneath this banner3.fa, we are pasting it over here. Now in the first case, when the page is getting loaded, the first icon, it will be rotating first. So I am making no changes over here, and it will be rotating for 2 seconds, and it will be rotating for 2 times. That means as a whole, it will be taking 2 into 2, that means 4 seconds. So in the second case, we need here to provide that animation time delay. There you go, animation delay. You need to provide a 4 second over here, delay over here. And in the next case, this will be taking 2 into 2, that means 4 seconds to complete this oscillation of this second icon. And it is executing an animation delay of 4 seconds, that means 4 plus 4 equals to 8 seconds will be consumed over here. So in the third place, that means here, it will be 8 seconds. Now you have set all those timings over here. As you can see that this is .banner2 fast spin, but the same thing what it is doing over here, you need to change this class name. This will be practically banner3 fast spin, and it will be having this animation delay. Banner2 on page loading, it will be rotating fast, and that is why there shouldn't be any kind of time delay. But once it stops its rotating, then this banner 3 will be coming in action. That means a total of 2 into 2, 4 seconds will be time delay that should be provided there. And that is practically provided over here, banner3.fastspin. Now it is in turn consuming another 4 seconds. It is rotating twice, and every rotation takes 2 seconds. That means 2 into 2 equals to 4 seconds. And here you have set an animation time delay as 4 seconds. That means 4 plus 4 equals to 8 seconds. And in the same manner, you need to change this class name. You need to take every precautionary measurement while you are copying and pasting something. Always remember to change these class names. As we are finished now with our coding, let's press Ctrl S and get back to our project and reload. You see that the first one is now rotating, it stopped. The second one is now rotating, it is stopped again. Now the third one is rotating and it is stopped. So this is the thing that we need to know from this tutorial, how to install this font awesome into our Bootstrap project and how to make customization into it. In the next episode, in the next tutorial that we are going to do, we are going to learn, if we click into these icons, these far icons over here, see, that another collapse drop down item is now appearing into your project. Same thing is followed in the rest of these two things. So this is practically is known as the accordion, and we'll be knowing about Bootstrap accordion. Practically a lot of things are remaining, those needed to be discussed first. And once we are done with our customization part, once we are done with our front end coding part, and then we'll be jumping towards our programming language, and we will know about implementing these programming languages into your front end development. So if you guys have liked our tutorial, then do not hesitate to hit that red subscribe button. Hope you guys have liked this tutorial, and hope to see you guys in our next tutorial. Till then, bye.